Hey, it's Hot Rod here at Transformers Ireland Online. Doing a review request for Danimus Prime. He asked me to do a review of Classics Hot Rod and Classics Optimus Prime. Optimus Prime will come later. I love the Classics line. Love it so much. Love the universe extension of that line. I just think they're absolutely fantastic toys. It's great to see G1 characters getting G1 updates that aren't just slapping a name on something that looks remotely like the character. That is Hot Rod, you know. It really looks like him. Albeit covered in dust because he's been on a shelf for a while. But I just love the Classics line. I think it's so much fun. It feels like I'm collecting G1 figures for the first time. Whenever I get one of these out of a box, I just love looking at them and checking out the detail and seeing where the design process went with it. So as we can see, Hot Rod is kind of similar to his Generation 1 vehicle. He's not as rounded or as smooth looking as the original toy or animation model was. He's much sharper, kind of aggressive, almost like a kind of a cross between a Lamborghini and a Ferrari Testarossa. But it's basically, I mean, when you look at it, you can tell it's Hot Rod, you know. He's low in the back and kind of high in the front. Comes up at the back, which is, this is why I was saying, it's like the Testarossa, very low here, very high here. And as for the, he's got the, you know, the traditional, what we're used to, spoiler and the exhaust pipes down the side. Color-wise, it's a very, very dark red. It's not as bright as the G1 Hot Rod. It borders on burgundy almost. The flames are kind of a very dark metallicized sort of yellow, almost a mustard color. Lights along the front are also this metallicized, but they're blue. And then he's got a kind of this almost flame colored spoiler at the back, a little bit more orangey than the mustard yellow here, with chrome and black, or silver rather, and black here for his engine piece. The silver is also here on the exhausts on both sides. Tires are black with silver on the detailing of the rims. On the rear, he's got black with red box outs to sort of signify stoplights, with a silver exhaust port. This later becomes his gun. And the windows are transparent blue. If you won't be able to really see it on this camera, but behind there is actually seats and a steering wheel, which I thought was kind of neat. And he comes with the rub sign that we're used to from the G1 figures, which turns Autobot. I believe there were a few of these and a few of Ramjet that actually came with a Decepticon sticker. So, no, I've seen a Ramjet when I haven't seen a Hot Rod. I know it's Rodimus in the line, but it's Hot Rod. So it's, you know, it's a cool enough toy. Scale-wise, I'm going to compare it next to Classics Prime. There you have it. You know, it's, he's a deluxe class, but he's about the length of Optimus Prime. I mean, this, he seems to be, you'd expect him to be bigger maybe in robot mode, but he actually stays quite short. So speaking of robot mode, we'll just put him straight into that now. And there is Classics Hot Rod. As I said, he doesn't really kind of get much bigger than the actual vehicle mode, but you know, I really do like this figure. I think he's just quite kick-ass. He kind of carries over the same kind of semblance of Hot Rod from G1, albeit there is a bit more Rodimus Prime to him. The head is very kind of, it's almost older looking. This head would have been great with the Energon Rodimus Prime, I think. But that's just down to personal taste. I thought that mold was a bit weak or lacking in the head design. Color-wise, you still get predominantly the kind of burgundy. Added to it is bright orange on here and here. Black on the shin guards. Yellow across the kind of waistline and silver on the crotch. And then black for his fists, which I thought was a weird colour because, you know, Hot Rod has orange for his fists, so I just, black I thought was quite strange, but hey-ho. And that's really kind of it, a bit of silver up there. Obviously, the face reveals that it's silver, and then he's got yellow kind of fins here, similar to that of Prowl, except that it's moulded into his helmet instead of being sat away from the top of his head. As I said, this is the exhaust, which just slots in to this part when it's extended in car mode. It does come with a firing projectile, as you can see. He's got the cross there. My kind of rule generally is that I don't use the missiles when I have them out. I don't like them. They just kind of look stupid, and they can free up space the less of them you have on the shelf. His is pretty crap. It looks like it's supposed to be kind of smoke. When you press this, it fires out, but I just don't like it, so it's not here, it's in a box in storage. But I think that's pretty cool. It's kind of a chunky kind of blaster. It looks like you could really do some damage with it, you know. Looks like it should fire miniature rockets or something. But he's just, that's just really kind of it as far as the figure goes, you know. He does hold on to the G1 kind of idea. What's great is that anyone who has the G1 figure will remember that when you folded the hood down, you got this gap here. Something they didn't fix on the titanium either, just between the back and the front. And they managed to do a good job of not having that problem here as well. One of the little features that comes with all Rodimus or Hot Rod here is that underneath this fist, you can actually put that in or leave it out if you want, but he comes with his little buzzsaw feature from the original Transformers movie that he uses to cut himself out of the tentacles on Junkion, or not Junkion, Quintessa, which I think is a neat little feature. I think that's pretty cool. It would have been great if this could have been a bit better, bigger maybe, and they use the same kind of thing that Dinobot has, in that you can just swivel this around and the other bit extends. So if you like, the buzzsaw part came out of here instead of here. But it's not so bad, you know. It's a nice little kind of feature. I didn't realize it was there, because I generally, with Hot Rod, you know, there's only one way to transform him, so I avoided the instructions for him. I didn't realize the buzzsaw was there for a while. Posability wise, you know, he's pretty cool. You can do a bit with him. The legs aren't really kind of the greatest, but they're pretty functional for when you want to pose them and put them on a shelf, you know. The hinge being on the arm, being low on the arm here, means that, you know, he kind of looks like he's got, his arms are too long, or they just don't look like they're bending in the right place, you know. But he is a really cool figure. I really like him. I know a lot of people say he's kind of too small, but, you know, it's Hot Rod. When you put him next to Prime, it makes sense. If they do a Rodimus Prime version, they can make him a Voyager class, I guess. But I really, really like him. I think this is the best Hot Rod that you're going to be able to get, that is poseable and retains a lot of the sense of the original figure, as far as updates go. Much better than the Titanium Rodimus Prime. And especially, like, miles ahead of the Energon Rodimus Prime, who is just very, very poor. Very poor figure. But yep, I would give him a good solid 4 out of 5. Alright, thanks, take care.